Raja, President, Indian Adult Education Association. Sri Suresh Khandelwal, General Secretary, Indian Adult Education Association. Members of ISEA, the awardees, of Nehru Literacy and Tagore Literacy Awards, distinguished guests, and other friends who are watching this program online. I'm very happy to be among this galaxy of eminent academicians on the occasion of the prestigious Nehru and Tagore Literacy Awards ceremony. Parliament is on, though it's not functioning as per the expectations of the people, but still is on. I am a little preoccupied with that. But as a person who knows the importance of the education, literacy, particularly adult education, and also the awards are given the name of the great sons of this great country, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, our first Prime Minister, Sri Rabindranath Tagore, two great eminent personalities who have done their best during their lifetime for the cause of education in the country. I would like to congratulate the Indian Adult Education Association for conferring the Nehru Literacy Award since 1966 and Tagore Literacy Award since 1987 to individuals and institutions that have made noteworthy contribution in the field of education and national development. Conferred in the name of these two great sons, as I said, these awards will inspire millions of our countrymen in the years to come to do their best to serve humanity by highlighting the lamp of knowledge. I always feel that these awards are not rewards. They are awards. One is in recognition of their great service, their contribution. Secondly, awards are given to inspire others to follow the footsteps of such great people who have done their best. That is the purpose of these awards. I also congratulate the recipients of these awards, Professor Ajana Rediger, Dr. Anita Dige, and Srimati Nishad Farooq, for their outstanding contribution to the nation building. Dr. Redeva Reddy, four of these people, in their own way, to the best of their ability, they have taken keen interest and also promoted the cause in various capacities and positions they held in public life. The importance of literacy and education needs no emphasis. When the world is moving towards becoming a knowledge-centric society, literacy and education have become the most critical instruments of development. Modernization, urbanization, communication, commercialization, and digitalization, among other things, have become essential aspects of the world today. And the world is moving very faster. Individuals and institutions need to adapt themselves according to the situation to sustain against this growing pressure. This is also necessary for understanding the socio-economic and cultural context so that you can orient or reorient yourself in tune with the changing times. As we are aware, high rates of literacy and educational attainments are directly related to a country's economic progress and the quality of life of its citizens. in a developing country like ours, India. Literacy is even more important as it helps better implementation and outcome of various developmental programs such as population control, health and hygiene, environmental protection, women's empowerment, and upliftment of deprived sections of society. Literacy is also a precondition for skill education and human resource development. Today, we are living in a time when reading and writing skills have become more essential than ever before. These skills not only instill confidence in a person, but also help in making one's social life more active and dignified. My dear friends, over the past 7 decades, we have made significant strides in the field of education. However, there still exists a huge imbalance in basic literacy skills in our society. This is a cause of concern, and we are marching forward, and we are now proving ourselves to the best in information technology and moving in digitalization. But the basic literacy, adult education, it needs to be provided greater attention, because the country cannot claim itself developed if you 20% or 15% or even 25% of your population are not yet educated. So it's a challenge to the country, to the leadership, central government, state government, various institutions. But I can tell you, with my own experience, you cannot expect the government to do everything. Should not depend. Government have many things. This is also an important aspect. But people also should join this. And this should become a people's movement. In every village, every town, people who are well-meaning people, who have some resources, knowledge, should devote some time to educate the illiterate people in their colony, in their society, in their village, in their town. This should be taken as an indication of the levels of civilization of that inhabitation. I say it intentionally. You are more civilized, that means there should be no illiterate at all. Illiteracy, poverty, growing economic disparities, urban-rural divide, social discrimination in certain sectors, certain places, gender discrimination, these are the challenges before the nation. Percentage may differ. You may justify. I am not commenting on the progress made by central government, state government and various ministries. They have done a commendable job. But still, we should not be satisfied with that. We should take this as a challenge. I know that we are a huge country, 130 crore population. So, we must take this as in a mission mode. As per the report of the United Nations Information System on for Education Plus, the gross enrollment ratio at elementary level has reached 97.8% in India in the year 2019-20. Very happy news, positive news. What is more heartwarming is that gross enrollment ratio for girl students at elementary level is even higher. It is 98.7%. Today, the total number of girls enrolled from primary to higher education is more than 12.08 crores. This is a very welcome trend. And I compliment all stakeholders at the center and the state levels who worked hard to make this possible. Society is realizing the need for girls' education. It is a saying, if you educate a person, you are educating a man, you are educating a person. If you educate a woman, you are educating the entire family. That is the importance of women's education. I'm happy when I go around the country, attend convocations, visit various institutions, or attend award functions. To my happiness, more than 65 to 70% recipients of the degrees or PhDs or gold medals are girls or women. This is a very happy news. The trend must continue. The Prime Minister started Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, Beti Badhao. That underlines the importance. The government is attaching to it. As I was telling, again I want to stress, this cannot be left to the government alone. Private sector has entered education in a big way. They must also, all private sector, the industries must take up this challenge. All universities must take up this challenge. Education institutions like colleges, schools, in and around them, they should take care to see that none is left as an illiterate. If this, every institution takes up this course, Saturday, Sunday, even for academic grading, if you take and give some recognition and marks to the students, to the staff also, how many people they were able to make literate, particularly adults, because the younger generation is going to study. They have realized the importance of education. The adults, they need to be educated. Minimum basic education literacy is the priority that has to be taken. We have attained near universal literacy among children. India's overall literacy rate stands at 73% as per the 2011 census. There will be some improvement further, but still it's clear that we have around 22-25% of the people illiterate in this country. This is not acceptable. The huge gap indicates that a large part of our adult population is unable to read and write, which in turn significantly hampers their ability to realize their goals and aspirations. It is really disappointing to note that India has the largest number of illiterate people in the world. There is an urgent need to correct this course in this context. The new education policy brings a paradigm shift in our education system, and the system has been developed to fulfill the aspirations of millions of citizens by realizing the Sustainable Development Goals 2030. Goal number 4 of the SDG 2030 seeks to ensure quality and inclusive education for all and to foster lifelong learning opportunities, which is also reflected in the new education policy 2020. This policy also gives due importance to the importance of various aspects of adult education. It proclaims the right to get elementary education and outlines the idea that the opportunity to get livelihood is important for all citizens. This approach opens new vistas of growth and development through availing lifelong opportunities of socio-economic and cultural development. Education empowers people. It arrests exploitation. It reduces corruption, discrimination, injustice. So we must see to it that this is taken on priority. The new education policy not only focuses on providing quality education, but also seeks to develop character, inculcate scientific temper, promote creativity, the spirit of service, and equip students with the capability to meet 21st century challenges. It recommends multiple avenues, including crowdfunding and utilizing online and app-based technology, satellite-based television channels, online study resources, and libraries for the development and promotion of adult education centers. I'm happy to note that the Indian Adult Education Association is doing an excellent work for realizing the ethos and targets of new educational policy. A lot has been done, a lot needs to be done. The government's schemes, Sarva Siksha Abhiyan, Samagra Siksha Abhiyan, Skill India, Mudra Yojana, Startup India, among many other schemes for skilling and gainful employment opportunities, these schemes will definitely help. So I once again urge all stakeholders, including private sector, to come forward and supplement the government's work in the field of adult education and skill training. Skill upgradation is very, very important in the present situation. There are inherent skills in every individual, but what is required is recognizing those skills, identifying, encouraging them, upgrading their skills. That also should be taken on priority, and once you are skilled, you will be able to stand on your own, and there are opportunities. I also suggest people to avail the benefits of government schemes like CSR, and I call it your PSR, that is personal social responsibility. CSR is for the companies, PSR is for every individual. So it should be taken as a responsibility for every literate person, educated person, to educate one person. Each one, teach one. This is, should not be mere slogan. Every one of us should be satisfied if we are able to teach one. Or encourage teach one, teaching one person at least. This should be taken on priority, and associations like adult education, they are very much necessary in the present situation. I am happy some of the people, well-meaning people, some of the retired people, retired but not tired, they have all joined together, in this adult education association. And I congratulate once again the recipients of the prestigious Nehru and Tagore Literacy Awards and wish that they continue with their work to realize the vision of a Sikshit or Samardha Bharat. Sikshit and Samardha Bharat. An educated and empowered India. For Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore, independence was like an award where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free. Dear friends, literacy and education liberate people, as I told you. They serve as the basic instrument of change and progress. As we celebrate the Azadi Ka Amrita Mahotsav in the 75th year of our independence, let us resolve to make our nation fully literate and educated. As I always assert, let us make India a Vishwa Guru once again. I extend congratulations to the Indian Adult Education Association and the recipient of the awards for their commendable work, and I hope that they will continue it throughout their life. Thank you very much. Dhanyavad. Jai Hind.